Hello, my cutie cubs! It's your boy, Zionic Blader, and welcome to another Worst to Best video. In this episode, we'll be ranking each cubbo from worst to best. We'll be ranking them based off their overall stats, their evolutions, and their place in decks. But enough talk, let's get on with the list. Number 5, Aurelis Cubbo. We start off rough with this dude having bad base stats and an evolution that is too expensive with no substantial boost to be worth using in general. This guy has an innate reroll effect, so I guess that's something. Number 4, Chaos Cubbo. Chaos Cubbo is pretty bad with low stats all around, and even with Frost Strike, what's the point? At least it's cute, but this isn't a cute contest, this is a... Number 1, Chaos Cubbo. Number 3, Ventus Cubbo. This is basically just a better version of Chaos Cubbo. It still isn't good, but I have dubbed thee the Canadian Cubbo because it was the first Cubbo to come out in Canada and came out before the US in a time where Canada was stuck in Wave 4 when the States was in Wave 6. Now we're stuck between Wave 5 and 6 and the States are in like Wave 8, I think? No one knows, actually. Number 2, Darkus Cubbo. Bad stats, but a solid effect, making your opponent discard cards if it opens with the least B power. Spam this to cause shenanigans. Number 1, Aquas Cubbo. I mean, come on. Look at those stats. Look at that face. The King of Magic Shield Fire Fist decks bringing in a nice B power of 1350 after landing on a Magic Shield core, and 1750 once evolved, which may add only cost 2 to evolve. Like, dang. Plus, this guy gives you access to the powerful negate, B power boosting, and drawing cards of Aquas, making Aquas Cubbo not only the best Cubbo, but perhaps the best Bakugan in the game. Agree? Disagree? Let me know in the comment section below. Like the video, hit the like button, or don't, I'm not the boss of you, but be sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell so you get updated whenever I upload. Until next time, see ya!